You're watching The Pulse on the Joy News channel on Malta TV. Now, involve communities in development planning. That's the verdict of civil society organization Send Ghana to the local government ministry on the assent of communities for the district development facility. At the launch of the first assessment of the DDF since its inception in 2006, Send Ghana revealed that the lack of assessment and monitoring of the project has been a major setback, explaining civil society advisor at Send Ghana, Mukaila Adamu, said though the assessment for qualification by the district is rigorous, the local government ministry must also include the community as well as punitive sanctions for defaulters. On the issue of delays in releasing the District Assembly Common Fund, while Mr. Adamu said the gaps have been filled.
Normally, assessments are done in previous year and the allocations are released in the next year. For instance, 2013 assessment is conducted in 2014 and funds for that assessment is released in 2015. So it's always a year behind. So I just want to draw the attention to the fact that the facility being in arrears for 3 years may not be so. We can say it's in arrears for 1 year.
So that's actually Mr. Amidu. He is a representative from the local government ministry who made it to the launch of this report on the monitoring of the DDF. Let's get more details now from Mr. Mukaila Adamu. Yes, he is the civil society advisor at Send Ghana. Thank you for coming, sir.
Thank you.
Well, when I first saw this report, I asked myself, how many people in Ghana even know what the district development facility is? Help us understand, what exactly is this facility about?
Thank you very much. The district development facility is just like the district assembly common fund, which is given to all districts to help in their development. But unlike the district assembly common fund, which is given to all districts, no matter what, once you qualify as a district assembly, you are given part of that resources to undertake development. The district development fund is a bit different. It's based on performance. Before you assess the fund, you need to qualify for an assessment, which is conducted by Ministry of Local Government. So it's not automatic that once you are a district assembly, you get the funding. You need to pass. And the assessment is basically based on their mandate. So it's not something different. If you fail the district development facility assessment, it means that the assembly is not performing its duties. Because they are just assessed based on their normal functions. There are two main stages of that assessment. First, you need to meet what we call the MC, which is the minimum condition for you to qualify for the district assembly fund. And those minimum conditions are areas like planning, budgeting, procurement, and the functionality of your assemblies, your district development planning units.
Okay.
So they are assessed on that. And if you fail any of the indicators for the minimum condition, it means for that year you have failed district, you have failed the FWAT assessment, and for that matter, you are not going to get the district development, district facility, development facility, at least for the basic and the performance grant.
Now, but this alone tells me something. Two things.
Yeah.
But one, if any district fails this assessment, it means one, you're not performing your function properly.
Exactly.
And secondly, did you not even qualify to even get this facility in the first place?
But there's some 20% of the grant which will be given to the assembly for capacity building. So for the capacity building component of the grant, whether you qualify or not,
you'll be given. And when they say capacity building, what does that mean?
Yeah, basically they do capacity assessment during the FWAT assessment. To identify capacity needs of the assembly. And then based on that, some specific amount, 20% of the grant is given to you to help in building your capacity to be able to perform your functions very well.
Okay, this is quite a good thing in terms of development of these districts. But tell me something, for Send Ghana, I know that anytime we mention Send Ghana, the first thing that comes to mind is District Assemblies Common Fund.
Yes.
Why the shift in focus now to the DDF?
Yeah, we've done a lot of work with the District Assembly Common Fund. And after some years, we decided that we should look elsewhere. And like the DDF, as I indicated, this is performance-based grant. It's not something for free. And we realized, like we were just saying, how many people are aware of it? So if assembly for one or two reasons fail to qualify. How many of the citizens in that district are aware of it, and therefore holding them accountable? So we decided that once we've done a lot of work with the District Assembly Common Fund, for instance, you talk about the 2% share of the District Assembly Common Fund for persons living with disability, we've done a lot. Even the deduction at source, we've done a lot. So we thought it wise for this time to also look at this. Basically because, one, it's 30% funded by government and 70% from donor funding.
Okay.
Which means that if we don't implement it well, it's likely that donors will not be happy and will draw from that. So and that is the more reason why we decided to look at the digital development facility.
Okay, that is good. Now, in your assessment and monitoring of the DDF, even those new, what are some of the things you found? How many districts, first of all, are unable to access this fund,
facility? Actually, we collected data from 25 districts out of the 30 districts that we selected from 2011 to 2013. And it was only one district that failed to access the fund in 2011. That's the Nadoli district.
Nadoli district?
Yes.
What was the reason for it?
It means they failed the minimum conditions. They were not doing their work well. For instance, the constitution of their DPCU, preparing of annual action plans.
Sorry, what is DPCU?
That is the planning unit of the assemblies.
Okay.
Yeah, they have a law for its constitution and also its functionality. Is supposed to be meeting quarterly. So they look at all these things. So if you fill any of the, there are 8 indicators under the minimum condition. And if you fill any of them, it means that you have failed the whole assessment.
Okay. Yeah. So one out of the 25 did not qualify.
Yes.
For those who even made it,
what
are some of the things you found out in your monitoring?
Yeah.
Are they using the money judiciously?
Sure.
As they should?
Sure. What we found out basically was the fact that when it was introduced in 2008, only 38% of assemblies in the whole country qualified. But if you look at the last assessment, which is 2013, about almost 90 to 95% of all the assemblies actually qualified.
Out of a total of 216
assemblies. So which means that actually it has helped assemblies to perform their duties very well. Like I indicated, it's based on performance. Mm-hmm. So if you pass the minimum condition, it means that the assembly is performing its duties.
Okay.
So generally we realize that it has actually built the capacity of assemblies to perform their mandate. That is the first findings. We also realized that the District Development Fund is in arrears. Those who actually qualify for 2013, as of 2016 that were collecting the data, have not received funding from the DDF Secretariat.
For 3 years. What's the problem?
The problem is that part of the fund, that is the 30%, is supposed to come from Government of Ghana. And sometimes it's difficult raising this counterpart funding. And that is one of the causes of the delay.
Okay, so it means that for the donors, their money is ready.
Yes.
But the 30% that's supposed to come from government.
That is the issue.
Has not come through.
Yes, that is the...
For the past 3 years, since 2013.
Not that, but that causes the delay.
Okay.
Until that money is raised, they are not prepared to disburse the fund unless they get 100%. So the donor fund could be ready, but they will also be waiting for government to release its counterpart funding of 30%.
And since your last check from 2013, 2016, they haven't paid?
No, you see, the last assessment is 2013.
Yes.
They are now doing the 2014, they carried out the 2014 assessment around early this year. So that means that one will come around 2017, 2018.
Okay, so surely we'll get the details sometime later.
Yeah.
But does this mean that with this, that you're monitoring, your eye is off the Assembly Common Fund assessment? Totally? You've shifted totally to the DDF?
Not really. We are still monitoring the two.
Okay.
But our emphasis is on the district development facility. As you indicated, our research finding even shows that 9 out of 10 people do not have information about the district development, even including unit committee members who are supposed to be part of the assembly.
Okay, but one thing worries me here. Yeah. Now, you've already mentioned that some of them are not getting the money. That's fine.
Yeah.
Others also qualify.
Yes.
Others did not qualify at all.
Yes.
The numbers considerably, if you look at 216 districts and only 90 are getting it, that means that quite a number of them still have a lot of work to do.
Exactly.
Is that not also down to the fact that these districts don't get the funds needed to do their jobs? Is that not it?
No. Like I indicated, if you look at the indicators for assessment, you have district planning unit and it's not functional. You are not attending meetings. You are supposed to prepare annual action plans. You are not preparing your annual action
plans. Maybe because there's no action.
Well, they have the medium-term development plans, which is for 4 years. And each year, they are supposed to go into it and select some project for the year. And that is the annual action plan. So how difficult is it? Do you need to get resources to do this? No. You have to prepare a procurement plan. Is it in place? So these are the basic things the General Assembly needs to meet every year, three times in a year. Are they meeting? All these things are just small, small things that they need to do.
Okay. Now, since you've been doing the monitoring, I think you're best placed to answer this question. Yeah. Every district is supposed to be that vehicle that drives development in every community.
Sure.
Are these districts doing that?
That is the point. They are actually not involved. Yes, to some extent, they are undertaking a lot of projects in the districts. But as to whether they involve the communities in the implementation of the project is another problem.
How is that so?
Yes, because the assemblies claim that they involve communities. And when you go further, what they tell you is that, yes, during the preparation of the medium-term development plans, communities are consulted. So all the projects in the medium-term development plans are from communities. That is just one aspect of it, because that is just selection of project. What about after that, and you prepare your annual action plan, and you are to implement a project in a community? Are they aware? Do they know the contractor? How much is involved in the project? Do they know? Even the selection of the sites, are they involved? That is a question that we need to ask. So in terms of selection of the project, yes, communities are involved. But when it comes to issue of implementation, monitoring and of the projects, they do not even know when the project is going to start and when it's going to end. How do they monitor? How much is involved? All these things are not known to communities. And the assemblyman who is supposed to be giving communities these information are also not doing their work. So everything is left in the hands of the contractor. As you can see, about 30% of projects started in 2013 were not completed as at the time we were doing the research. Why? Because delay by contractors. Not because there's no money, but just delay by contractors. Because nobody is monitoring the contractor. The communities that are supposed to be monitoring are not aware. They don't know much about the contract, so they are not monitoring them.
Okay, so clearly there's a gap that needs some filling.
Yes,
but for St. Ghana, what is your plan here in terms of helping to monitor for this DDF?
Thank you very much. St. Ghana is different from other research institutions, because we are not interested in just coming out with the findings and just leave it like that. So what we're going to do, at least in the 25 districts that we collected data, we are going to use this same report to engage all the assemblies. We are going to organize what we call district dialogues, where we'll bring all these assemblies and we'll present the findings, and together we'll see how best we can deal with some of these issues.
How then do you also deal with the districts that are not performing, that are not doing things right? How do you help them to get on track?
Yes, like I said, we're going to have that meeting. So that in that meeting, we'll bring all the stakeholders in the district together to discuss, and then to see how best communities should, and the point is that communities should be aware of it. If they are aware of it, they would rather put pressure on the assemblies to perform. Because if you don't perform, what it means that you are losing money for a district, which you could have been used to produce, provide schools, hospitals, chief compounds for our district. So that is why we want communities to know what is happening, so that they can hold their assemblies to account.
Okay. Yeah. I just need to find out something. For this facility, what kind of projects does it cater for? So are we talking school buildings? What are we talking
about? Yeah, that is a discretionary fund given to the assembly to implement their medium-term development plans. So the assembly can decide what to use the funds for. But basically, looking at the project, that about almost 70% of the project were into education, and the rest health sector. So basically, most of the assemblies are using it to construct classrooms as well as chip compounds.
Sorry, did you say chip compounds?
Chips compounds,
Because I know for the chips compounds, there's quite an elaborate program by government to cater for that.
Yes.
Nonetheless, the DDF is taking care of this?
Yes. Some of the communities,
some
of the districts are using the funds to construct chief's compounds.
Okay. Thank you so much for coming, Mr. Mukaila. Clearly, a lot of work needs to be done in the districts across the country for development. But this report will help us to identify these ones and see what we can do collectively to monitor the reports so we see development, real development, in our district. But thank you for coming, sir, for your time.